A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 8th December, Sunday. On the front page, you have Priyanka Akhilesh linked Unnao rape case accused to BJP. So, Unnao rape case accused Sengar is a BJP MLA from Uttar Pradesh. So, this here you can see demand is being made for justice for this rape accused to. And here you have justice can never be instant. So this is what Chief Justice of India Sharad Arvind Bobde said, that justice could never be instant and it would lose its character if it became revenge. So that is what we are seeing in the Telangana incident. Cyberabad police, it killed all four accused in the veterinary rape and murder case. They were killed in an encounter. So, and after that, you can see another rape accused has been attacked by mob. On page 5, you have COPD treatment eluding power loom workers. So this is regarding COPD. This is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So this is an irreversible lung congestion caused by long-term exposure to organic dust. So it's an occupational disease which affects the power loom workers. So this respiratory disease is many a times misdiagnosed as TB in the absence of detection facility. So this and any government scheme for this. So how power loom workers are affected by this is covered here. On page 9 you have measles outbreak continue unabated. So this is World Health Organization which says both measles and rubella can be prevented by highly effective vaccine. So children under 5, age of 5 years account for most of the people who die from measles as such. So that is why World Health Organization is calling for vaccination against measles and rubella. So we have the MR vaccine initiative which the government has taken. So India initiated one of the world's largest measles rubella campaign to eliminate measles and control rubella in the country. So World Health Organization says that measles cases more than doubled in 2018 compared to 2017. So now we'll have to see 2019 figures. On page 10 you have BJP confident of getting citizenship bill passed in Rajya Sabha. So BJP, you can see, seeking support from allies and a few others too, so that the bill could be passed. So here you can see the NDA and which parties it is seeking to influence to get the bill passed. On international page you have Iran US swap prisoners amid tensions. So this is Chinese born American who had been imprisoned in Iran over spying charges. So exchange of prisoners has taken place. And another news is India hires lobbying firm Cornerstone to reach out to Democrats. So after several lawmakers have criticized New Delhi's India's decision to dilute Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir, India has hired a lobbying firm to reach out to the Democrats in US. On business page, here you have the news that personal income tax rate may be cut, but this has not yet been announced. And here you have a good start but challenges begin now. So this is RBI Governor Shaktikant Das who talks about how his government has taken efforts to improve government-RBI relationship. So the progress report as such, after he took charge as 25th Governor of RBI, is given here, the positives and the challenges. Then on Sundays you have FAQ coverage. So here the important issues over the week are covered in detail. So first one is, what are the laws on rape and sexual crimes? So have they changed over the years, and when was the death penalty clause included? So after the 2012 Nirbhaya case, many changes in laws have taken place. So this complete detail is covered. Even government later amended POXO Act too. So these details are covered here. And this is seeking a review of creamy layer reservations. So this is regarding creamy layer for SC/ST. So why does the government want a relook of past judicial rulings in connection with promotions of SCs and STs too? So this is the issue of creamy layer, where creamy layer presently applies to OBCs. So whether it should apply to SCs and STs too, whether reservation should be there in promotions. So all these questions Arrays. It is said by the time of at the time of entry, all SCs STs may not qualify for creamy layer, but at the time of promotion, some of them may. So if creamy layer is brought in, then reservation and promotion may be difficult. So that is it. And even a reservation and promotion should not be there is also a point highlighted. And this is Curvy stock scandal. So this is regarding SEBI. It had banned the stockbroking firm Curvy, which had misused the power of attorney of its clients, so for its own personal gain. So it has been banned by SEBI from taking on new clients. And what happens to the clients? Curvy had approached the appellate tribunal. Securities appellate tribunal sat on the matter. So this complete detail is given here about this issue. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here the first article is, a typhoid vaccine manufactured in India offers 82% protection. So unlike the other two vaccines, the tested vaccine can be given to babies who are just 6 months old too. So this is typhoid vaccine called Tibar TCV. It has been developed by Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech. And it shows 81.6% efficacy in preventing typhoid fever at 12 months in a phase 3 clinical trial. Then this is novel molecule to combat multidrug resistant bacteria. So this is a molecule identified by IIT Roorkee researchers. It kills the bacteria by damaging its DNA and inhibiting cell division. So here you can see. So multidrug resistant bacteria like Escherichia coli, Acinetobacter, and these Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So it can fight against these bacteria. So this is the molecule. The molecule belongs to nitrofuran class of antibiotics. It is called nitrofurantin and furazolidone. So they are routinely used for treating urinary tract infection and intestinal ailments respectively. And this is 2.3 million children in India unvaccinated for measles. So India is second highest, next only to Nigeria, with 2.4 million people here, you can see. So estimated cases and deaths are much more than what countries have reported is also what World Health Organization and UNICEF say. It's a preventable disease. It can be prevented through two doses of vaccination. But number of children who are not vaccinated against measles is alarmingly high in six countries, in which India and Nigeria are the top two. So 2.4 million children unvaccinated in India. So in Nigeria, 2.4 million. India has reduced from 2.9 to 2.3 million children, which remain unvaccinated. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage, in which imported international news over the week are covered. So this first one is on Sri Lanka. It says Sri Lankan Malayalis keep their Kerala connection alive. So this is Narayan Guru, the leader, Kerala's social reformer. So he has become a unifying force among the Malayalam speaking people. So you should know about Narayan Guru, the social reformer from Kerala. And this is a World War II artifact find its rightful owner. So how a descendant of Diwan of Multan traced the journey of a Japanese family's photo album is covered here. We can skip this. Then this is Red Tourism. Again, it was covered last Sunday too. So you can skip this to Red Tourism. At least you should know the term. What is Red Tourism? So Red Tourism is basically tourism to communist centers or communist heritage history of China. So it says Red Tourism is part of President Xi's anti-poverty drive. So places associated with 1949 revolution like Zuni, Humao are attracting many visitors. Then this is protesting for reform in education, getting charged with sedition. So this is what is happening in Pakistan. So students are holding rallies in across 50 Pakistani cities seeking greater say in running of universities. You can skip this too. So the only important news here may be only for Sri Narayan Guru, you should know about the social reformer. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.